Okay. Today, I will talk about some use cases of artificial intelligence in our company, how we implemented them, what are examples, and how we benefit from them. I will just try to summarize. Okay, the first project I want to mention about that is SEMA Face Analytics Platform. By the way, SEMA, the word itself in Turkish means face, so its name is important for us. So this platform, as you understand from the name, focused on face recognition and face analytics. We have some custom developed age detection, gender detection, emotion detection algorithms. Also, we have face recognition algorithms, face verification algorithms. In this platform, we combined the whole algorithms into single product, and we also developed some API support, so it can work both real time by using APIs, or it can work on batch manner. It's easy to integrate solutions. We integrated the platform in Turkcell applications, some of the Turkcell applications that I will mention in the later slides. Also, we can able to integrate it to outside of company using these API capabilities. The first real life example is fraud detection. In Turkcell, we have 33 million subscribers approximately, so we have a huge database. Also, we are one of the top companies that frauders want to fake us and get fake subscriptions and use them for some other purposes that we do not want. So in this project, we just using our face recognition algorithms, we processed our whole database, images of the people, subscribers, and then encoded them privately. And then when a new subscriber tries to get new subscription, as you know, we get some identity cards and face information on it. So we on real time check it our database. If there is a very similar face or the same people maybe, or the same photograph maybe, we just create a new alert to the fraud team. And some people on the fraud team manually also cross-check it. And then if there is a really fraud case, they stop the activation process. Or if the subscription is activated already, they can stop it, they activate it. This is one case. Another case is for some passports, especially in the pandemic conditions, our fraud team detected some type of image recognition patterns that the fraud passports have. So we implemented this solution with image recognition techniques, and on the real time also, we can process these passports, and then if this pattern matches that passport, we can create new alarms, and our fraud team can also check it. Another example is digital onboarding. In Turkcell, we have an official application, and by the boosting effect of the pandemic, you cannot go to physical stores, or do not want to go to physical stores. You can just get a Turkcell subscription in your home by using our mobile applications. You can go through the appropriate menu. You can take photograph of your identity and your selfie. Our AI algorithm cross-check it if the photos belong to the same person. If it is okay, then the next process starts. The algorithm also generates a random text and request person to read it. When the person read it, our speech to text algorithm converts this voice data into text data and compare it. If the matching ratio is above some threshold, then the process is completed on the mobile side, and then after a few hours of activation period, you can get your physical SIM card by just simple cargo companies. So it's so simple. Another application of this digital onboarding is our Paysal solution. It's a mobile payment solution in Turkey. So the similar period, the similar process is also applicable on the Paysal application. Another interesting capability is our image regarding image recognition and analytics capabilities is this smiling campaign. We developed a custom solution to detect people's smile using deep learning, and also we scaled it to some levels, smiling levels, and detect the smiling level of the face. And we used this application for funny reasons in our team and also in Turkcell, within Turkcell. But our marketing team has a clever idea that what about opening this solution for the sake of society, to who customers, to who subscribers. So that campaign was that. We integrated this algorithm into our official mobile application. People take their selfies and smile on it. If the smiling is above some level, we feed some animals with their food for these people, for their smile, actually. So the campaign was important in that site because it's almost reached over 1 million people in the Turkey. So it was a very huge ratio that in Turkey AI-based campaign is also applied. So it take our this solution took some awards both in Turkey and also outside of Turkey. And this campaign was so successful, the second round of it generated. It was the same scenario, but the prize was not foods for animals, the prize was trees for forests. Another application is face recognition based office gate system. It may be a very common solution, but it's in-house developed solution that we can enter our offices just using our faces, even if we had some masks. Another solution is our smart cam solution that we deployed on our physical stores. We can count number of people and detect gender of people, age of people, also detect where they are moving, what products are they are analyzing or they are looking at. So it's a smart solution for us. Another solution is smart parking solution. We also developed it for not close auto parks and open sites. So it's simple algorithm detects cars and slots of the parks of the cars, and then tries to guess if the slot is full or not. Another our prototype type is driver behavior analysis. So we implemented this solution to detect if the driver is actually looking on the road or eyes closed or not, or looking at this phone, etc. So we can detect these type of scenarios and generate real-time alarms based on video. This solution is also used in some Turkcell official cars right now. Another our solution is Photopic application. This is also an interesting solution. we also developed an algorithm that which photograph will be most liked in the social media. So we developed an AI algorithm, a custom algorithm for that. It's simple. Life, by the way, Lifebox is an application of Turkcell that it's similar to Dropbox. You can store your files, photos, etc. So in this application, our algorithm is integrated. You can just provide four or five of photos to this application, and the AI algorithm selects which one will be better for or the best for the social media for sharing, and also it look at the content of the photo. Let's say if there's a people on the photo, a group of people on the photo, or the weave in the photo, nature weave, etc. So it creates automatic hashtags, and our application also has integration with social media, popular social media applications. So you can just click on and share it with hashtags without having to write it again. So this Lifebox solution is also applied to some event scoring in some summits or events, etc. People take photos and share it on the social media as well. So we created an extension of this algorithm that it processes the social media data of people, collect photos of the people that they are attending on the summit, if they permit us. Then using these collected photos, score them and try to guess the best one for the social media. And we also provided some small prizes for this type of events. Another application is harmful detection algorithm. Right now we use it on the BIP solution of Turkcell. By the way, BIP is an instant messaging application owned by Turkcell. It's similar to WhatsApp. So during the real-time messaging, people send, as you know, lots of videos and images. So in some channels or some groups, there are some content that we do not want to be shared within WIP. So we developed an algorithm that detects some harmful contents that are not appropriate for the BIP solution and blocks them. Another funny solution is TechSummit solution that in interactive meetings and especially like this summit, but because of the pandemic, we are not on physical site, we are just online site. In some type of discussions, moderator wants to ask the audience some questions or get some direction of audience. So the classic method was moderator ask a question and people says A or B, please raise your hand. Then people raise their hand and the moderator counts them individually and decides the direction. We developed a solution that people can express their preference by not just raising their hands, raising their phones. We have some phone detection algorithm detects the phones raised up and then counts them. And then you see on the left-hand side, calculates the preference and gives to the screen for the moderator. Another solution is also a common solution, but it's in-house developed in our Turkcell building. We using the also Paycell application, as mentioned before, we provide a face payment methodology and algorithm. So you can just register your face into this application and then match with your credit card or some ticket card, etc. Then you can use it as a payment method. Another application is emotion detection variants of application. In Fizi, by the way, Fizi is another Turkcell solution, mobile application. It's rival to Spotify that you can listen some songs, etc. So by the selfie method, when you take your selfie and provide this application, our emotion detection algorithm runs and by detecting your emotion and the recommendation engine generates new recommendations for you specifically. Another solution is money detection solution. It's just developed for disabled people, not for commercial reasons. By mobile application, disabled people just take photo of the banknote and our algorithm decides the number on it or size of the banknote. And then also using our text-to-speech algorithm, the application reads the size of the banknote to the disabled people. Another solution is AI-supported alarming, RPA alarming methodology. As most of you know, all companies have some dashboards or some map dashboards. We have also a bunch of them. Our algorithm, this is the operation dashboard. Some KPIs are bad, then this city becomes red, yellow or green according to these KPI values. Our RPA solution frequently checks this dashboard, and if there is some red region, just focus on it. After focusing it, getting more details, and then send to these details to operation contacts on the field or on the headquarters, etc., which is the responsible team. Then this solution also can answer some questions, or it has also some conversational AI capabilities. Sorry for Turkish content, but the application runs on Turkish. It makes some jokes to people regarding weather conditions or other cases, or in some aid, it celebrates the aid of the operation people, etc. Another example is movement anomaly detection. As you see on the right side, there is a cat on our data center. We can detect it and detect the movement, and also detect the object of the movement, if it's a cat, it's a person, etc. Or we can detect some regions that people should not enter, and these type of detections all can create alarms to related operation team. Another example is traffic prediction project. It's a time series prediction type of algorithm. It's very important for Turkcell because most of the investments are planned of the traffic estimations in some regions. There may be some increasing traffic, and so you should invest to these regions, etc. So our algorithm both works data traffic or voice traffic, because the patterns of these traffic types are different. So we are actually using it on our investment planning or daily KPI operations, daily monitoring systems. It's all integrated. We also have some voice assistances. Also, I'm checking my time. A bunch of voice assistances integrated to our solutions. I'm just going through very fast. Also, this is a non-commercial solution that disabled people who cannot see, cannot read the SMS messages on their phones. So for this registered people, we provided a solution. Text of the SMS was converted to voice. Our text-to-speech algorithm, and then this voice message is also sent to these people. Another example is we integrated our solution to this voice generation text-to-speech algorithm that some articles or some newspaper content are voicely generated. So to people who are on the car or on some other type of places that cannot read but can hear, they can use it. Another voice generation example is our internal educations. Right now, most of our educations are not read by humans. They are read by AI algorithm. Also, another non-commercial application that for disabled people who cannot speak, we have a beep channel. On this channel, they can just type the content or type the sentence or words. They can instantly get the voice conversion of this text content, and they can just click and listen it, or make people around them listen it. Another example is HR interview solution that during the interviews, we of course we can get the permission from candidate, and after this permission we can detect the emotion of the candidate, emotion history or time frame of the candidate, and also the textual analysis that if he or she is speaking fast, low, or what type of words he or she is using mostly, etc. So we are using these AI solution to get best candidates. Another classical AI solution is chatbot. In Turkcell, we have more than five chatbots right now. The most popular one is the customer chatbot that's integrated on our mobile solution and our website. Also, we have some internal chatbots for specific teams that can make their life easy. We have some internal portal for call center agents. In this portal, we provided some speech-to-text algorithm. They are not just have to type, also they can type for searching some content, but while they are on the call center, the time is very limited, so it's easy to use speech for searching. So we provide this solution internally. Also, we provided some auto-suggest or exclusion list or did you mean features to this portal using our NLP capabilities. Another application is text analytic harmful content removal. In
sorry, Ismail,
most
we
of
have just 2 minutes.
Text-based solutions.
2 minutes.
Okay,
time.
Okay. I'm just time to skimming it. Harmful content may be detected. Text analytics methodologies and applied. We have also recommendation engines, and we have also some other non-commercial solutions or projects in the health area. And finally, we are working on some robotic assistant, like in the picture. We are planning in the few years to deploy this robotic assistant, which is AI supported assistant, on the physical stores to help people on the stores. So that's the end of my presentation. Thank you for listening to me. And if you have some questions, I'm
thanks a lot.
Ready to answer.
Thanks a lot. So we have just 1 minute left. If there is any question, I was writing to participants. So there is a so Jose Matias is saying a very useful application to retail. Thanks, Ismail. How hard was it to find the technical talent to work on AI within the company?
Yes, actually, it's not easy, basically. In the AI team, we get some talents, but it's not easy to find ready talents that they have their know-how, very full know-how, and they are very well educated. So we had to internally educate the candidates or talents, but we try to find the best one, but it's not easy.
Okay, thank you so much. Though I don't have time, but one question for Ashish Sharma. He has a question. Let's unmute him. Ashish, go ahead. Yes. Ashish, we cannot hear you. Can you? Ashish, I cannot hear you. So, Ashish, we couldn't hear you. As well, I cannot hear you, Ismail. So, Ashish, you can. You know what we can do? Ashish, because time is over now, during the networking breakout time, you can ask any question you wish or get connected to Ismail on LinkedIn. We have made a LinkedIn page for all participants of this summit. I shared it with you by email, but I will share it again. During the presentation of Haider, I will share it on the chat area so that you can get connected and you can communicate further there. Okay, Ismail, thank you so much for the presentation.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. If you can switch off the camera, please.